Well, how much do you spend each year to heat your home? Thousands of dollars? Well, how would you like to spend just $300? That is becoming a reality in the coastal town of Belfast, where super energy efficient homes are now under construction. Once built, these homes will be given the distinction of being the most energy efficient homes in all of New England. In tonight's Project Economy coverage, News 8's Jim Keithley paid a visit and shows us how it's all possible. Jim?
Well, Tracy, Maine, of course, has the seventh oldest housing stock in the country, where 80% of all homes still heat with oil. Now, we've heard, of course, people using solar power and even geothermal, but this project in Belfast is not only super energy efficient, it's affordable for everyday people, and the savings on heating costs are stunning.
Belfast Village. It doesn't get more picturesque than this. Antique homes line Church Street, but these houses usually come with ugly fuel bills. One, for instance, takes 1,000 gallons of oil to heat, adding up to $3,000 to $4,000 a year in fuel costs. But just down the road, this brand new two-story, three-bedroom home is furnace-free.
A lot of the features of this super insulated house you can't see, and that includes the insulation that's under the floor, in the walls, and in the roof. And it's insulated to about three times what a typical new house would be insulated to.
What we can see are these very large, expensive windows from Germany, and the doors, so thick they resemble a bank vault. These elements cut down on the need for heat.
And there really isn't much of a heating system. When people ask me that question, I point to the south-facing windows. Basically, because about 75% of the heating is coming from the sun. And it's passively heating the space, it's heating the concrete floor, that stores the heat until it gets cooler in here, and then it releases it, typically at night.
There's no basement. Gibson shows us the utility closet, a giant hot water heater, and up on the snow-covered roof.
We have active solar panels on the roof that make electricity. And the amount of electricity they make is greater than the amount of energy that the house will use for heating. So essentially, by investing a bit more money in those panels, you are guaranteed 25 years of no heating bill.
In the attic, a ventilation system that circulates the air, and there are those tiny electric baseboard heaters.
For the little bit of supplemental heat you need, it ends up being about $300 of electricity for the whole heating season. So because the house is so well insulated and so airtight, on the coldest day in Maine, when it's 0 degrees outside, we can calculate how much energy you need to heat on that day. And in this house, it's about the equivalent energy that a hairdryer puts out, or about 2,000 watts.
In the past, this type of advanced energy efficiency has been cost prohibitive for the average Mainer. But this one is different. The homes start at $150,000 for the smaller one bedrooms and go up to $333,000 for a four bedroom.
The bottom line is you spend about $15,000 more on a house like this. And over the course of, say, 30 years, you save about $150,000 in energy.
Down the road, construction is underway on the 36-unit Eco Village, as it's called. 22 units have already been sold. Santa McKim is among the future residents who have bought into this project. She says the energy savings is just part of the appeal.
You know, the average person can buy into it. So in our case, you know, sustainability is stuff like heating, you know, having basically no heating bill. It's transportation. We are a very easy bike ride to town. We're 2 miles to the harbor and about 1 mile to shopping and Rennie's and Hannaford and jobs and all that kind of stuff. So you really could be car free. There are a couple of our members who are thinking, yeah, you know, it could almost be like living in a city where I don't need a car.
Now, about half of the people who've purchased homes in this project live within a 20-mile radius of Belfast. We're told the other half from all over the place, Texas, California, Pennsylvania, even Austria. Now, the first phase of this project should be completed sometime in May. Live in the studio, Jim Keithley, News 8.